Hey there, welcome to Comet. I'm Gretel from Customer Success, and in this video, I will help you get your Comet backup started in 8 easy steps. First, you need to set up a Comet server. The Comet server is your central management for backups and devices, which you can access on a web portal. You can either use a Comet-hosted server, which we maintain for you on an AWS account, or you can use a self-hosted server. In this video, we will go through the basic setup on a Comet-hosted server. You can add a Comet server in the My Services tab. You can choose your AWS region here. Click on Create Comet-hosted after choosing a region. The start guide is extremely helpful and will walk you through steps to run a backup. Please do not skip this if using Comet for the first time. And with just 4 clicks, we now have a Comet-hosted server. We will follow this guide to start our first backup. To set up a self-hosted Comet server, check out our video linked in the description below. For now, let us continue with this setup. Now that we have set up a Comet server, we can follow the first step in the Getting Started guide, which is to add a user. In the Comet server, click on Add User. Type in a username and password. The username can't be changed after creating the user profile. On your initial setup, if you were using a Comet-hosted server, Comet Storage would be pre-configured as a storage template. This means that we can automatically generate a storage vault for this new user. We have now created a user in the Comet server. Here, you can configure client settings such as time zone, language, and email reporting, among others. Next, we need to download and install the Comet Backup Client. This is step 2 in the Getting Started guide. Click on Download. You can download the client installer here. There is an installer for Windows, Linux, Mac OS, and Synology devices. The system requirements are summarized here. These are covered in more detail in our process guide, which is linked in the description below. For this video, I will download the Windows installer. Extract the installer from the zip file. Launch the installer and follow the prompts. The client software is now installed on the device. The next step is to log in to the Comet Backup Client to connect it to the Comet server. In the Comet client, log in with the user credentials you set up earlier in the Comet server. And the Comet client is now logged in. Back in the Comet server, you will see that the device is registered under the user I logged into. Now, I can manage this device from the Comet server. Next, let us configure a protected item to backup. A protected item refers to the Comet backup product, such as files and folders, disk image, VMware, and so on. You'll find a full list of our protected items in our product page, which is linked below. This is step 4 in the Getting Started guide. Follow the prompt to add a protected item from the Comet server. Choose the device with the protected item you would like to configure. By the way, a protected item refers to the Comet backup product, such as files and folders, disk image, VMware, and so on. Choose the protected item to configure here. In this demo, we will set up a basic file and folder backup. Here, click on the folder icon to select files and folders to backup. And after selecting items to backup, click on Next. Here, you can configure commands that run before or after this protected item is backed up. This is where you can configure your backup schedules. As you can see, it's possible to set up multiple backup schedules and assign them to different storage locations. Click on the plus sign to add backup schedules. After configuring the backup schedules, click on Save. Please have a look at the guide linked below for more information on retention options. For now, click on Save. We now have a protected item to backup. Next, we will add a storage vault to set the storage location. This is step 5 in the Getting Started guide. A storage vault sets the location where the backed up data will be stored. The fastest way to set up a storage vault is by requesting it from a storage template. To configure a storage template in a Comet hosted server, go to Settings, then Storage. If self-hosting the Comet server, you will find storage templates in the Authentication Role section. To continue with our demo, back in the Comet hosted server, click on Add. Click on Type to choose a storage provider. You can create a storage template for these storage providers. Configure the bucket name, access key, and secret key, and hit Save. You now have a storage template configured. The next step is to request a storage vault from the storage template we have set up. Follow the prompts to do so. Here, click on the storage template you would like to request a storage vault from. And we now have a storage vault where we can store backups. For more information on how storage vaults function, please check out the guide linked in the description below. Without a storage template, you will need to set up a storage vault manually following these steps. You can configure most S3 compatible cloud storage as well as on-prem storage as a storage vault. And with a storage template, a storage vault can be requested as a new user is being created. New users would have a storage vault configured, no manual setup required. And now that we have a protected item and storage vault set up, we can run a backup. This is step 6 in the Getting Started guide. Follow the prompt to run a backup from the Comet server. You can also run backups in the Devices tab here. And the backup job is now running. Next, we will cover the steps to check on job reports. This is the last step in the Getting Started guide. The Protected Item tab will show the result of the last backup job. Click on the link under Last Backup Job to access the job log. The job log can be exported. To view current and all historical job reports, go to the Job History page. You can specify job types to look up. or you can pull up all of your job logs. And there you have it. We have run our first successful backup with Comet. Those were the basic steps to get started with Comet. Sign up with Comet now to discover other cool features and backup types that you can configure. Just click on the link in the description below to start your 30-day free trial. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.